Hello and welcome to this painting video. In this video, we're going to show how to paint the red and gold of the Adeptus Custodes. Now, our example is going to be an Allarus Custodian. Before we begin painting, however, we'll need to undercoat the model. And as you can see here, I've used Retributor Armor, which is perfect for the colors we're going to be using. Now, I'm going to start first by shading or washing over that armor. For this, we're going to be using Gunnerman Flesh thinned down with a little bit of Contrast Medium. Now, I'm going to use two parts Contrast Medium to one part Gunnerman Flesh. So let's begin doing that. So I'm going to use that as the measuring tool. So that's one paintbrush of contrast medium, and that's number two. Give it a quick wash and a wipe. I'm just going to get a paintbrush of Gunnerman Flesh. And all we're going to do is mix that together. That's a nice amount of thinned down Gunnerman Flesh. All we'll now do is start applying that all over the gold details. Just be mindful in case it starts actually like pooling at the bottom. And if it does do that, just use your brush to soak up any excess. With the Gunnerman Flesh and Contrast Medium mix now dry, what we're now going to do is move on to applying the rest of the colours to the gold. So I'm going to start first by tying up some of those raised areas using Retributor Armour. Then we're going to layer over, just add a bit more punch to the gold with some Auric Armour Gold, and then finish off with a highlight of Stormhost Silver. But first of all, let's start with that tidy up stage. So this is just getting some Retributor Armour, just applying a little bit to the palette, a little bit of water, so it's not too thick and goopy. You can see how I'm using a small layer brush as well. So just make sure I get a nice point to that brush. And then all I'm going to do is then just start picking out those raised areas and just tying them up. Take your time, make sure you leave a nice bit of that Gunnerman Flesh in those recesses. With the raised areas now tidy, what we're now going to do is get Auric Armor Gold and just layer over. Again, this is going to add a little bit more punch to that gold. When it catches the light, you'll see it just has a nice bit of bling to it. There we are with the Auric Armor Gold now applied. What we're now going to do is get Stormhost Silver and do a nice edge highlight around all those details. With that silver highlight now done, our gold is finished. So what we're now going to do is move on to the red details. Now I'm going to start first by using Mephiston Red as a base coat. Once that's dry, we're then going to get Flesh Terrors Red and thin that down with some Contrast Medium. So two parts Contrast Medium to one part Flesh Terrors. We're just going to drop that into the recesses. With that dry, we're then going to tidy back up using Mephiston Red and then finish off with a highlight of Wild Rider Red. But first of all, let's start with our base coat. So what I'm going to do with every base coat is just apply a little bit to the palette, a little bit of water, just so it's not too thick and goopy. And then make sure I get a nice point to the brush. And what we're then going to do is just start picking out. We'll start with the robes at the back. Don't forget to do the plume at the top as well. Now that we've base coated the red, what we're now going to do is get Flesh Terrors Red and coat over. Now I've thinned this down with two parts Contrast Medium to one part Flesh Terrors Red. And take your time. If you do find it pooling at the bottom, just use your brush to soak up any excess. With the Flesh Terrors Red now dry, what we're now going to do is just re-tidy back up using Mephiston Red. Now that we've tidied the cloak up with Mephiston Red, we're going to finish off with a highlight of Wild Rider Red. Just at the base of the cloak, I'm just going to use the edge of the brush to get a nice consistent line. However, in some places, like the folds of the cloth, I have to use the tip of the brush, so just take your time when doing that. And there we are, the red and gold of the Allarus Custodian is now done. And remember, by following these methods and techniques, you can easily transfer this to any model in your collection. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this video. Hope you enjoy painting your own red and gold on your Adeptus Custodes, and we'll see you again soon. Bye-bye.